Dice Age is made possible thanks to the support of our patrons. We'd especially like to thank our living legend, Silgwyn. Thank you very much, and enjoy the show.
The Empire of Maka has existed for nearly 1,000 years. Founded and ruled by Avon the Main, the Immortal Empress, it quickly expanded its borders thanks to the overwhelming power of its mages and the shrewd politics of its nobles. Now it has fully conquered the center of the continent of Elmera, and although war has ended, peace still eludes its populace. As the Empire nears its first millennia, the signs of turmoil have become more frequent and apparent. Monsters are becoming more bold, nobles plot schemes of usurpation, and whispers of rebellion hang heavy in the slums. This gave rise to the adventurer. These strong individuals of all races and classes lend their might to the citizens of Maka to drive back monstrous incursions. There are even adventurers who perform deeds so noble that the people can see beyond their race to the hero that lies within. There are those who criticize these adventurers and claim they're nothing more than pawns used to advance the political machinations of nobles. Despite the Immortal Empress herself making fewer and fewer appearances, there are those whose faith in the Empire remains unshaken. But the wise know that it only takes a few sparks to ignite the flames of change. Allow me to introduce you to these sparks. Welcome to Elmera.
Hello and welcome to Dice Age, an actual play D&D show. My name is Jack and I'm the Dungeon Master. With me as always are our wonderful heroes. Would you all please go around and introduce yourselves?
Hey, I'm AJ and I play Edgar Wood, the Half-Elf Bloodhunter.
Hey, I'm Alice Rose and I play T, the Elven Sorceress.
Hey, I'm Dakota and I play Esaraeus, the Human Rogue.
Hey, I'm Zach and I'm playing Tauros, your Tiefling Paladin.
Hello, I'm Trey, and I'll be playing Oberon Pursuit's Master Mr. Manius Quinius Alexander, your Drow Fighter.
Wonderful. AJ, do you have a recap for us?
Yeah, so I was actually just trying to do some research into where we are, the Central Forest, all that. And apparently the Claudius Laboratories has a commercial. I was incredibly confused why, but then I listened, and I think it understand why, and also I think it does a good recap.
All right,
I think we should just play it.
Yeah, let's get that booted up.
Are you sick and tired of living a worthless life? Have you wished for more purpose? A cause to get behind? I have the place for you, Claudius Laboratories, where anything is possible. Come meet a diverse group of staff who will take your every need. Heavy bags? Peanut butter on a shelf that's just too high? Our helpful Garistro doorman is there to help. And don't worry, anyone who may want to do you harm will have to deal with him first. Just look at those horns. Claudius Labs offers the cutting edge in magical service. From magically heated blankets to teleporters that let you navigate through the space with ease. Just don't go where you don't belong, otherwise the labs will have to teach you a lesson. Isn't that right, happy guest?
Yes. I am very happy here at Claudius Labs. I no longer have to think for myself. I just do. And when I make a mistake, like touching a key I'm not supposed to, Claudius Labs takes care of me immediately. Thank you, Regulus Claudius the First. Thank you, Claudius Labs.
That's right! At Claudius Labs, we do the thinking for you! Hear what our other client has to say. Or should I say, oh say?
I thought I knew who my allies were. But after meeting with the kind and powerful Osei, I learned I couldn't trust anyone. But the experts here at Claudius. So I mercilessly killed my so-called friend. Thanks, Claudius Labs. Praise the Empire.
Exactly. So come on down to Claudius Labs. If you're physically strong but mentally weak and awful at incredibly easy puzzles, we would love to have you. You may even get to meet the other experts or, if you're extremely lucky, a member of the Claudius family. And we promise, if you get to meet the patriarch himself, it will be a life-changing experience. Join us! The Empire demands it!
Well, that was certainly an informative advertisement.
I don't think those guys were getting paid. I'm just gonna say it.
I think they were getting paid too much.
They volunteered. They were very giddy about it.
Yeah.
Alright, well, with that being said, I guess we should just return to the world of Elmera. So, you all find yourselves back in the room where you've just defeated the Osei. The purple key that was hanging around his neck has dropped to the ground. And the madness that was clouding Edgar's mind and the confusion that was clouding the minds of T and Woon has dissipated. And as you all look around, you will also see a very incredibly beat to hell Tauros, as well as a significantly beat to hell, but not as much, Oberon.
I guess I'm not here then.
Well, Essa's there too, but Essa is...
You will see a barely tapped on, like, the tip of the elbow, Essa.
At one point, though, I was, like, fighting that damn thing, so shut the fuck up.
Yeah, I'm sorry, but did you die? Because Tauros almost did.
Yo,
well, that's not what's killing you.
Yeah, better get good. Get good.
Are you all going to be wanting to take a short rest after the events of this fight?
Well, immediately after the fight's over with, Oberon, like, shrinks back down to normal size and, like, plant stone cleaver in the ground, having to use it to like just help keep himself up for a lot of it, and just turns to Edgar.
Edgar is on all fours, hands like clenching at the stone, not able to look up as he's shaking.
Yeah, Tauros is also in a similar position, just on the ground, but he, like, he, you know, like, gives a handle, like he's okay, kind of.
Let's block off the door. Let's look to rest. Some of us need to get our strength back before continuing on.
All right, yeah. You all can move into the room.
I want to grab the purple key.
Mm-hmm.
And as we're getting ready to go, just like Edgar's on the ground, Oberon's not going to, like, he's going to kneel a little bit and just come on. We can talk about it later.
Edgar just kind of stays. He gets up a little bit, just kind of stays, not looking at Oberon.
Yeah, and then once they start to move, if Edgar follows Oberon, it's not going to push him too much.
It takes a while. He lets there be a good gap in between before he does follow.
All right, yeah. Yeah, I was going to say, you guys do have the key, so if you want, you can lock the door behind mm-hmm. that you came in through if you want to secure this room mm-hmm. For your rest.
Yeah, I think so.
All right.
Go ahead.
No, go ahead.
I was like, question, when we re-engage the log, does it look like it resets the trap?
It does.
Okay. So this just goes, now we're good in case anyone, we sense anyone coming up.
Yeah. Hopefully. Let's get situated for a rest. Those who aren't as injured, mind taking watch?
Yeah.
Sure.
I can do that.
All right. Those who are taking watch, give me perception checks.
Woon will also be taking watch.
What for? No, advantage, so 12.
18.
Woon with advantage, so 11.
Okay. Okay. We're going to go ahead and anyone who's rolling hit dice during this short rest, go ahead and you can please make your rolls.
Yep.
Taurus kind of like almost drags himself to a wall and just kind of like pushes himself against it.
So I'm going to roll one, just trying to see if I can get back. Okay, damn near at max. That's going to be fine. What?
It's a whole bunch of hit dice being rolled right now.
A lot of people got real fucked up.
Oh, yeah.
I'm also rolling like shit sometimes.
You already used your second wind during the Osei fight?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, yes. I'm at 70 right now, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 4 dice, 70, sorry. 128. Okay, I'm only 7 hit points down. I'm gonna go ahead and just use one more. Might as well.
Nice.
I wouldn't have had to roll, but two of them. Okay, I'm back up to full.
As
well.
Mine. Ooh, rough.
I was just going to say, as we're resting, Oberon's still going to like see that Edgar wants to maintain a set distance. He's just going to sit down. It's going to be okay.
Edgar's in the corner. He's got hands on knees at this point, just trying to shrink himself into the smallest possible. Now, knowing Tauros isn't possibly looking at him, he is just staring at Tauros in that moment.
I imagine Tauros is like actually like clocked out. Like you see, he's like straight up snoring. Like asleep right now. Yeah.
So Tauros, you're gonna keep using hit dice.
I was gonna use my last couple.
How much are you still down by, or are you back up to full?
With that 19 he just added.
Not bad.
By my count, you're down by 20 hit points.
Yep.
You're down by 20 hit points. Oberon's going to toss you one of his graders.
Alrighty.
So 44 plus 4.
Yep.
Oh, wow. Not bad. Closes the gap pretty good.
Yeah.
Jack, if you'll allow, Edgar is like taking the beat for the hour, but he's refusing to heal.
Yep. If you don't want to use hit dice, you don't have to use hit dice.
Yeah.
You'll still get all the benefits of a short rest aside from expending hit dice.
Cool.
All right. So the hour passes. As you all are keeping watch, at one point, T, you're standing watch by the door, not the one that you all came in through, but the one on the other side. At one point, you hear what sounds almost like the flapping of wings that seem to approach the door, stop, and then start flapping back away.
I'll make sure that everybody knows that I heard something, but that it's not actively a threat at the moment.
Mm-hmm.
We'll just have to keep an eye out.
Sure.
Once everybody's good, Oberon's just going to like stretch some of the cricks out, and he's going to open this door.
Okay. Using the key?
Yeah, of course.
The key. And he just opens it.
Yeah, you open the door, and Oberon, with your crazy good dark vision, you can see straight through. Well, I mean, the place is illuminated, so it doesn't matter, but yeah. Still. You do see straight through to another octagonal room with a green teleportation circle.
Do we have a green?
You do not have a green key.
Yeah. I think that we need to head back the other way.
Mm-hmm.
Essa, I'd recommend that you scout ahead, knowing that there is something else in there.
Well, Essa just nods. Stick behind.
Yeah. So you all backtrack to the orange teleportation circle.
Yeah, let's say Essa staying like maybe like a good like 15 to 20 feet ahead of us, yep. Like scouting out stealthily.
So you head back to the orange teleportation, which takes you back the way towards the red teleportation circle. And then from there, you head back through the antechamber to the blue teleportation circle. From there, going back into the room that had the lightning puzzle, and then heading into the there's the yellow teleportation circle there that you have not gone through yet.
Everybody ready?
Ready as I can be.
So,
here.
Okay.
I think it's safe if we keep the formation of Wound being in front of T, at least for right now.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I just gotta gather you all up so it makes it easier for me to drag and drop you.
Perfect.
Alright. You all go through the yellow teleportation circle, and you emerge in another octagonal teleportation room leading off to a hallway with a door. So go ahead and assume your marching orders.
Do you want me to roll a spell since we're
Everyone who is being stealthy, give me a stealth check.
Try.
30.
Nice.
I'm at like 15 feet ahead, so about there.
Suppose we should all roll, yeah?
One and a
boys.
Two.
We're rolling great tonight. That's a good sign.
S is like, really stealthily.
I'm gonna give myself disadvantage.
My wound has four.
Still better than everyone else.
Yeah. How, as you guys are walking through this, how's T and Woon, how are you looking after dealing with the confusion? I imagine you're probably not as shooken up as Edgar, yeah. But
we didn't go as hard as they did. We didn't get as afflicted.
Mm-hmm.
Honestly, Tina's like a little embarrassed, but you know, everybody in the room knew that there's mind control happening. Y'all, however, you know, she's respecting the difference in our experiences.
One has to be shaken up. First Tauros, now T.
Yeah, Woon has trust issues now.
No.
If you try and pet him, he doesn't growl, but he definitely does like skirt away.
Mm-hmm. Kind of sticks closer to Oberon. Okay, so
first you confirmed the stereotypes about tieflings, now half elves.
three quarters, first of all.
Two thirds.
Three fourths.
That's a Gilgamesh.
No, three fifths. It's three fifths. God. Or was it two thirds or three fifths? I think it was two thirds.
It's two thirds.
It was two thirds.
It's a god and a demigod.
Yeah. Okay. Anyways, so Essa, you're scouting out ahead, so your stealth check is by yourself. The rest is a group stealth check. so you move up.
You know what's sad? You could almost add all of our individual stealth together and not hit 30.
Yep.
I did the math. Yeah, I think it barely clips it.
If you got rid of one,
if we didn't count Woon's stealth check, then
Woon only got a four. He shouldn't have had advantage. So,
I think it clips 30. I think
it equals 30.
This is like S is like, I'm really stealthy. Just here's behind him. People
you're stealthy. You're stealthy by proxy because there's so much noise going on in the.
Honestly, they should have given you advantage on your stealth check because of how bad they're doing. So you get up to the door. As you like, I'm imagining like you're pressing your ear against the door to like check what's going on. It's like, give me a little perception check.
18, not bad.
You hear a gentle beating sound, like as of like wings coming from within the room.
As a like, would TF describe the noise, like the wings?
Definitely.
Mm-hmm.
Like as a like kind of. Like kind of motions that like it's the same creature or might be the same creature that he heard earlier.
Is it sounds small, like you know, like a bat's like, wings or just
no? They sound like
massive unfurled wings,
like something like something forest? Fairly large.
Massive.
Something akin to the kind of sound that you would hear when Tauros's wings are flapping.
That's a sound of bitch.
He ain't wrong.
It's Tauros. We have to fight Tauros.
Oh, I can definitely kill it then.
You could take this one off.
I'm gonna wait
training for module.
I'm gonna wait for everyone to get a bit closer before I lock the door.
Alright. You all move on up. So I am guessing is it Oberon and Tauros in the front?
Yeah, keeping the front.
Alright. Put them there. Edgar right here.
Wound between T and the door.
Alright. So, Essa, you open the door.
Mm-hmm.
And inside the room, you all see a large, sort of avian-looking humanoid. They're wings and plumage makes you think almost of a pigeon with how they look and then they look out to you I'll say if you weren't standing right behind the door your stealth check would have absolutely made it so that they couldn't see you, but unfortunately
S is like, ah fuck, why are you looking this way?
They look to you and say, are you the group that bested Ose?
That would be us.
Shame. I thought that they were stronger than this. And we're gonna roll initiative.
See, if I had any form of range, I would have, when he asked that, I would have just shot him in the face. Mm-hmm. Like, this your answer?
The thing is, I would have done that if I had a magic weapon. I have a magical ranged weapon.
Damn.
I cast Power Word Claw Darter.
Okay, it took me a second to realize what you said. Clogged hard, that's great. Oh, that's bad that he goes, I have a bad position for him to go first.
This shit. One's got good dexterity.
He's a merge.
He's fine.
It's also bad that I am right there.
This will hurt. Right. That's fine.
I think it's my turn to get my ass kicked.
T is also going to go before me because she has a higher dex than me.
Okay. All right. So they are going to see you all just kind of bunched up in the hallway.
Mm-hmm.
And they're going to look. Yeah, that's a point within 60 feet of them. Cool. A radius of 15 feet. Is going to hit everyone. Cool.
Oh no.
Is this a spell?
This is a magical effect.
Hmm.
If it's something that would protect against a magical effect, that would still qualify, but this is not a spell.
Understood.
So they point at this spot, and then suddenly from all of the over the ground, all over the walls, all over the ceiling, weapons of every kind suddenly emerge. You see great axes, spears, halberds, all sorts of things suddenly erupt from the walls, ceiling, and floor. And I'm going to need a dexterity saving throw from everybody.
Is it bad that I thought the things on his token looked like microphones before I realized they were swords?
Yeah. 14.
25.
That is so much better than I thought it would be.
Oh, yeah.
11.
It's a great dex save.
Oh, wait.
Don't forget that everyone gets, I believe everyone's within Paladin Aura.
Yeah.
Except for T.
T is outside of Paladin Aura.
So that's an 18 for me.
Go ahead and ignore Wounds Initiative. You can knock them off the tracker, Jack. I accidentally put it.
Okay. What was Wounds' original initiative?
He doesn't have one. He goes after.
Oh, right. Okay. So, anyone who got less than an 18 fails.
Okay, I just made with Paladin.
Me and Woon. Me and Woon.
And Taurus.
All right, so I'm going to roll 10d8 slashing, piercing, and bludgeoning damage.
Oh, holy shit.
Is it
10d8? Like combined, right? Not 10d8 each. Right?
No, combined. Combined.
Okay. I was scared.
This damage is all weapon damage types.
Yeah.
Okay.
30 DA would be hilarious.
Oh, hilarious.
52 piercing, slashing, and bludgeoning damage. Essa takes no damage because of evasion. Yeah,
thank you, Taurus.
Everyone else takes 27 except for Wurm and Oberon.
Hold up. Okay.
Just looking at something.
And this was Malthus's Demon's Arsenal ability.
That's fucking sick.
After that effect happens, the weapons recede. It doesn't, like, they don't stay there.
No stay. That's good.
Very good.
You're just in us for the rest of the fight.
Yeah.
But that was Malthus's action. So now it is Tauros's turn.
All right. We'll scoot on up here. Gonna get a lay of the land and my spells aren't looking great. Yeah, I'll save my spells. He'll just take a shot off with the longbow.
Okay.
You may want to afterwards, like, scooch over to the sides
out of the way. Yep. Shot one. That's only a 10.
No, that won't hit.
And turn off at Fantage. And shot two is an 11.
Oh, 11. My God, Zach.
He's back.
I'm sorry.
Hey,
I got to kill the cat. I don't care. I got to kill a fucking cat. I'm okay with this.
Sammy's hurt right now.
So Malthus is kind of like their wings are beating and they're kind of like hovering like 5 feet off the ground. As you like shoot two arrows in quick succession, they just beat their wings and the gust of wind just knocks the arrows to the ground.
That's cool.
And they say, "You'll have to use something you're better with if you want to fight me." It is Edgar's turn.
All right, I'll fight you with trauma.
Okay, we're
going to move up. Worse with that than a bow.
Our 40 feet of movement, get as close as we can. Not fully, just in case this thing's got fucking crazy reach.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we'll go 20 feet away from it. 20. We'll go here. And we're just going to take two shots with our longbow.
Okay.
30.
30 will hit.
Crit.
There we go, baby.
Oh, shit. For 14 piercing.
All right. Cool. You shoot the bow, and the bow hits. However, you get a sense that despite Malthus not having like any strong looking armor on them, that they kind of like roll their shoulders as they get hit with this arrow and don't take the full 14 damage.
Sure. So I guess it doesn't matter if it's magical or not, gang. 14 again.
14, so for another 7 damage.
I guess bludgeoning, slashing, piercing are not going to be our best friends in this scenario.
Yeah.
That's all we do.
Yeah, the problem is we don't have besides tea.
Not a lot we got tea.
He's a demon. He resists fire.
I'm going to bonus action Crimson Right the Claudius Rapier as I put away my bow.
Okay.
For 4 damage.
And Malthus holds up their whip and just kind of points it at you and says, know this, mortal. Weapons will find very little use against me. For I am their nothing. Master.
Utterly nothing.
I am gonna say nothing.
Alright, it is T's turn.
Good. I'm not moving.
Why not?
You know, I don't want to join the party. Let's see, I'm gonna cast a fireball.
I mean, you could try it.
I don't think there's a point that you can put it in this room that doesn't hit anybody.
Demon, fire, small room. You know. That'd be funny.
Well, I'm just catching up on all of the fun private messages we have on our little Discord.
Yeah.
Are they great?
Don't worry about it. I'm going to cast something I think I've casted once before. Mm-hmm. I'm going to try blindness deafness.
Okay, not a bad idea.
And they're going to be blinded.
All right.
Hopefully.
You go to cast blindness. You're casting it, and you know, because you fought these demons before, mm-hmm. And they've seemed to be able to... something about their nature just makes it so that they aren't as easy to hit with magic. But when you go and cast blindness, you see that this creature, this demon, does not get that same resistance to magic, as it will not make this roll with advantage. So what is the saving throw for blindness deafness?
It's either con or wisdom. Blind or foe,
choose a creature you can see within range, make a con save.
Okay.
Yeah.
Con save for Malthus is a 19.
Oh,
fuck. It passed.
Damn.
That was good, though. That was good.
Mm-hmm. You do. So, what I'll say, you don't get to blind Malthus, but you do learn that Malthus does not have magic resistance.
That's knowledge gained. Yeah. And that's not a wasted turn. Let me just see. Let me read my character sheet. You know what? Field research. I'm going to spend 2 key points to quicken Firebolt.
Mm-hmm. I think you mean sorcery points, but sure.
Yep, that's what I meant. What did I say?
You said key points.
Key points.
Yeah. I didn't know.
Sorry.
This bitch got monk on the mind.
Yeah, I do.
She's got her mind on her monkey.
Spending 2 sorcery points to quicken a fireball.
Absolutely.
2 sorcery key points.
18 does hit Malthus.
Holy shit.
Holy shit. Christ. That's the best I've ever
rolled.
Oh
my god. yeah. No, 20 to hit. 20 damage.
20 damage.
And Malthus takes the full 20 fire damage.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
There you go.
Cool.
Good to know.
So okay, I learned.
You've learned that Malthus not only does not have magic resistance, but also does not resist fire damage.
Oh, I love learning. Okay, that's my turn. I learned a lot.
You shoot that off, and Malthus looks at you. Seems to like peer past wound. Somehow you can tell that they are looking directly at you. And like kind of clicks their tongue in annoyance.
Shit, I'm gonna be the target. Good. That's gonna be
Oh, don't worry.
Now, I will say, you can move to the side and you can get behind that wall and you'll break line of sight from Malthus.
That's very smart. I'm just gonna move a little.
Just a needle.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Hyper-teach useful? What is this?
All right. Right? Oberon.
Fucking the upside down.
Are you gonna share your findings with the class?
Yeah, I'll just shout it out quick.
Okay. On hearing that, good information, and Oberon's just gonna immediately dash up. Not actually take the dash action,
right.
He's got 40 feet of movement. Move up, and as he does, each like step that he takes, you see bits of the floor like adhere to parts of his armor. As I'm going to cast my stone rune, so I now resist bludgeoning, piercing, slashing.
Beautiful, make it an even playing field.
Yep, and then we just go in for three swipes on this guy.
All right.
Twenty-one
will hit.
For 16.
16 half to 8.
26.
Will hit.
For 11.
11 half to 6.
And 28.
28 will hit.
For 17 half to 9.
All right.
Does that 28 beat his armor class by more than 5?
It does indeed.
Cool. Stone Cleaver.
Okay. That's a con save. Yep. That's a 27 on the con save. Sure.
Damn.
That's the second charge of Stone Cleaver.
I've still got two charges left on it.
So you are hacking away at Malthus, and they're just kind of like letting you, they're not showing any real reaction as the axe is hacking into their body. And then as you like take a second, you try to activate Stone Cleaver and they just like beat their wings, and any stone that was starting to accumulate on their body is just thrown to the ground. And then Malthus like looks away from T to you and says, "I'd like to try that axe."
They say ass.
They say ass.
When he says that, Oberon just like snarls up at him. Gotta get past my dog first. And with that wound bounds up to him.
Mm-hmm.
With 60 feet. He's going to be able to get through there. And as Wound does, Wound is going to bonus action. That same kind of stone aura armor appears on Wound, as Wound is going to use his once per day of the stone to give resistance to all those.
Beautiful.
And is then going to take 2 attack.
Oh my god. For a
natural 20.
Hell yeah.
For, oh my god, that's such ass damage.
Double ones.
So 7 double combined ones damage.
And 2 twos. Mm-hmm. Yep, 7 combined damage on that crit. Nice.
Unfortunate.
Nice. Cool. 22 though.
Will hit.
Which does more damage than the crit did for 8.
Alright.
Yep, and that's my turn.
As you say, you'll have to get past my dog. There's a beat as Wound is charging up where Malthus just goes, "What's a dog?" And then
this thing. Fuck, we had a moment to do an up dog joke. Damn it.
God damn it.
It's
damn.
Okay. We'll get a matter baby in there somewhere.
It is now S's turn.
All right.
That's always a shame when the rogue is last in the initiative order.
Well, it actually kind of helps because Wound's there, so can the bonus action dash to get there. Fatoosh. And then I'm going to take a stab with lightning needle.
Okay.
Yeah, because of the extra elemental damage. For 20.
20 hits.
Alright, stick attack because I ally within 5 feet and had advantage. So it's 33. Total weapon damage plus 10 lightning damage.
Okay, so that's 33 halved to, would that be 17?
17.
So 27 total. If he takes
and then takes the full 10 of the lightning damage.
So yeah, 27.
All right. Any additional movement from Essa?
Just to pull myself out of danger, I'm going to use, I said, move 35, 5, 10. If it takes an attack of opportunity, that's fine.
Yeah, Malthus is going to swing, crack their whip at you.
All right.
With disadvantage, as Woon is going to use his reaction to use his defender martial role to impose disadvantage on any creature within 5 feet of him whose target isn't.
Okay. A disadvantage on the Great Whip?
Misses.
Okay. Yeah, Woon goes for a swing with the sword and it throws Malthus off balance as you run away, evading the whip. Malthus's turn is going to roll a d6.
Fuck.
Yeah.
That's gonna hurt.
Let's see.
That's gonna hurt some.
Fuck us.
Motherfucker! God damn it.
Teehee.
Yeah, center it on Tauros. Go center it on right Tauros. There. You got the right idea.
No, go right for idea. The stupid dog! Kill that dog!
Alright. So Malthus is going to summon the demon's arsenal once again. Targeting Essa, Oberon, Edgar, and Tauros.
God damn it.
15.
Jesus.
I don't get the aura.
God damn it, it's a fucking 7.
I don't get the aura. It's, you don't have the big
thing. I don't get the aura.
No one gets
Tauros, no one gets such a shitty paladin.
You die!
Everyone failed, so everyone's going to take the full 10d8 damage as once again...
I take half.
Oh,
right. Oh,
and
sorry.
Essa takes half.
Yes.
Could you make the save too just to see?
I rolled so fucking well on that roll too.
So that is going to be 43 damage.
Okay. Alright.
Halved to 22 for Oberon and Essa.
Okay.
God, ow. Damn.
I am looking hurt.
I'm looking real fucking hurt, guys.
There went all those hit points.
Mm-hmm.
Alright.
I have 4 hit dice left.
Man, it's a real shame that Demon's Arsenal recharged, because now they can't use the Great Whip attack.
Oh shit, that's too fucking bad.
So they are going to attempt to put some distance between them and Oberon, and is going to fly 20 feet into the air.
Swing.
Yep. That'll
21,
hit.
He does not. Yep. He does not go anywhere.
They are so unable to damage. Move and take 6 damage. Okay. It is Tauros' turn.
Bro, I'm literally have 2 level 1 spells, 2 level 2 spells, and 2 level 3 spell slots left.
Hey, Tauros, that's 6 fought... more spell slots than I have.
That's so true. We haven't even fought the gross Uncle Grandpa we have to hunt down. God damn it. I can't use any more fucking spells.
Fucking AKA the Grunkle.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just gonna try to shoot him again.
Okay.
If this don't work, we'll just fucking rush him and die. Let's go, 24!
We'll hit.
Let me make sure all my shit added on to it.
If you get your improved Divine Smite, I believe.
Yeah, because it's a weapon attack. It's not melee weapon attacks, it's just weapon attacks.
Bing, bing, boom.
So it's going to take 11.
Yes, it takes 11. Yeah, they take 11 damage because of the combined Radiant and Piercing.
And then shoot again.
That's another hit.
Yeah. Hell yeah.
Ooh!
For 10 damage.
Oh,
yeah. Nice.
All right.
That's my turn.
Edgar. Hey, Edgar, do you want to, like, transform or something?
Nope. We're gonna run right there.
Okay.
And we're gonna take two swings with the rapier. Two stabs. Yeah. Two pierces. 18?
18 just hits.
Beautiful.
I think Alice rolled an 18.
Six. Okay, so 10 of that is piercing.
All right,
and
so
then
that's
17
five.
Is elemental.
And then 17.
So 22 total. So
22, yeah. All right.
That also
25
hits.
For 13 piercing. It's 14.
21. 21. 21.
13 piercing, and then another 8.
14.
Then,
so yeah,
21. 14,
so 21.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Malthus is starting to look hurt. And I believe you only get 2 attacks, correct?
Yes. Do I want to? No, we're good.
Mm-hmm. T.
Great. Y'all immediately got right up in his business, so I cannot tragically cast Fireball.
And you can't.
Or you.
Could.
I totally could, but like, I don't know.
I mean, it'd be pretty hard to cast Fireball when you're looking at a wall right now.
Well, thank you very much. I feel like Wound holds a grudge, so I don't want to. 5 feet to the right, and then, fuck it, we'll go for Scorching Ray.
Okay.
Just hit him with heartburn.
Why not?
Heart attack.
Heart attack.
Just hit him with your ischemic attack.
The 23 hits.
She's back.
Yeah, I assumed. That's 7.
Okay.
And then I'll quicken another firebolt.
Okay.
Oh my god!
Yo, let's go!
All right, wow. Maybe friendship ended with Scorching Ray. Firebolt is my new best friend. Holy fuck!
Oh, oh baby!
29
damage.
Shit.
Holy crap!
I think this is the most damage.
I crit fireball and did 29 damage.
I think this is the most damage Alice has done in a hot minute.
Mm-hmm. I think this is already the most damage I've done in an entire combat encounter combined.
No, I think this also includes Asia.
I think you did more. I think you did more damage to the Sword of Madeira with like your 30 damage fireball that you fucking hit her with.
God damn!
All right, that was nice though. That was nice.
Very nice.
Yes.
Very, very good. Very good.
All right, that's my turn.
Nice, Oberon. Let's see it.
I move right there, so I get advantage.
Okay.
And then I smack.
Yep.
Smack.
For 7. For 6.
13.
Hi. You did it.
5.
18.
7, yeah. 6, 5. I was really hoping.
7, 6, 5.
Yep.
And then I move right here.
Okay.
And then Wound is going to... first, Wound is going to bonus action second wind. So
okay.
He is going to heal. Okay. Heals... 18 hit points.
Okay.
That's almost... Yeah, I'm not going to say... Wound is now up a good bit better.
Yep.
2 attacks. Bonk.
Oh my god.
Let's go.
Well, yeah.
There we go.
Let's go 2011.
Yep. That hits.
For 8.
Alright. Malthus is real fucked up.
Good.
Essa.
Yeah. Go ahead, Essa.
Essa, right. can you take them out?
Let's try. We're going to walk up. Advantage. Main attack with lightning needle for 19.
We'll hit.
That hits.
Get sneak attacks. That's 30. That's 32 half to 16 plus 4 for 20 combined.
This is still standing.
Bonus action. Bonus action. Dual wielding attack.
I was going to say. Then move out of his reach.
Bonus action. Do you want to do a bonus action offhand weapon?
Well, I can still move out of his reach and he'll like have him
after
attack.
After you stab him.
Yeah.
So bonus action second attack. It's gonna have to be with the end because Hold on. I think that's only when that's attuned, so I can't add that. Bonus action, the end. For 15, damn.
15 will not hit, unfortunately. Yeah.
Happens. Backing up.
All right. Malthus is just going to let you go because they are too hurt to risk an opportunity attack right now.
Pussy.
Does he know that I can hit off of that? I haven't hit him with that.
You have hit with an opportunity attack.
Only when he ran. When he tried to go up, he doesn't know that I can hit him if he hits somebody.
Wounded. Wound blocked him.
Wound blocked.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. In that case, I don't... Well, no. Malthus does know that you have the Sentinel ability, though.
Does my man read the player's handbook?
My man,
my
man is the master of all weapons. I think they know what things people can do with weapons.
Okay.
Can I make like a persuasion check to taunt him into attack if he has a scream pussy as I run away?
Yeah, go for it.
You deserve a nat one.
That's a 21. It's almost a nat 20.
Nice. You needed a 54 to succeed. Okay. It's Malthus's turn. And Malthus is going to bonus action pull out at the start of their turn, they're going to roll a d6. Does not recharge, and now is going to pull out of their pouch a supreme healing potion.
Fuck.
Lol.
Fair.
Smack it.
Very fair. Fuck.
All right. And now is going to go for a great whip attack against Oberon.
Great whip?
With disadvantage, as Wound's going to use his reaction to impose disadvantage.
Okay.
Nice.
Ah, damn. Ooh. Only a 19.
Miss.
Sorry, what were you going to say?
Does this big whip look like the big one from Bloodborne? It's just like a dragon spine.
Sure. I don't know what whip you're talking about, but yes. I will say something I also forgot to mention is that anytime Malthus is making an attack with a weapon or showing or using a weapon, the weapon is apparating from like the air. Like Malthus's weapons.
That's right.
This is going to be another whip attack against Oberon.
Like a blade works.
They're unlimited.
But no longer with disadvantage, correct? Protection is just for...
It's only the attack.
23.
Hit! I'm going to Blood Curse of the Eyeless. That's so I'm going to subtract a d6.
Okay.
Fuck.
All right.
Thank you for trying. I'm good. I resist it, so...
So that is 18 slashing damage halved, and now you need to give me a strength saving throw.
Oh, no. I just read what that does.
That's
okay. So the whip coils around a stone cleaver, but does not find purchase as you wrench the axe back from Malthus. And with an angry curse, Malthus goes for one final attack with the whip. And it does not hit.
Missed.
Oh.
Yeah, so after that second one, he tries to yank Stonecleaver out. Oberon kind of just, as far as he can, slams it into the ground, just pins the whip there for the rest of the turn.
Okay. Malthus is going to curse, disapparate the whip, and then just try to take flight and move the 20 feet into the air.
Okay.
And we all get.
Yeah, I was gonna say Edgar also gets one, right?
Edgar doesn't get one.
He technically leaves my reach, or he never leaves the reach.
He doesn't leave the reach, but also Edgar used your reaction for the blood curse.
Yeah, and Wound used his reaction, so only I got. But he doesn't go anywhere, and then it takes 70 points of damage.
Yep.
Poor guy. Sentinel, man, it's fucking broken.
I love Sentinel.
Tauros.
It's one of the best martial
fields. I know you do.
Yeah, you do.
Josh, we're gonna shoot this bitch.
Okay.
Shoot his ass.
Hit him.
With a gun.
Shoot him with the fucking gun.
They actually heal 24 from
hits.
Mm. Ugh.
For six damage.
Six.
And the shot.
Does not hit.
All right, it's my turn.
All right, Edgar.
All right, two stabs. 26. For 12, that's half to 6, and then 14, so 20 total.
Okay.
24.
Hits.
For 17, ooh, half to 9, right? Yeah.
Plus 13. 9 plus 13.
22.
Edgar, in the last fight against a demon, you had your mind horrifically altered. How do you want to finish off this demon?
There is a violence after the first hit when Edgar realizes that this thing is ripe to go down, and just again, no face change, still just a straight face as he's just stabbing constantly in vital parts of the body, just chopping through whatever it can, piercing it all the way through until it finally stops moving.
Yeah.
And coldly wipes off the blood and walks away.
Yeah, Malthus hovers, like, that last 5 feet of air that it was hovering on kind of drops to the ground, and they just sigh and look at you all and say...
As it goes to talk, there is a rapier in the mouth. I'm not letting it say anything.
And then it erupts into a burst of smoke and sulfur as it leaves behind a green key.
Go and grab it. Turn to the others. As much as I would love to take a rest right now, I don't know if we have the time.
What potions do we have?
Agreed. Horus will knock back one of his greater healing.
Where's gonna,
I have one greater. And that's it.
MT is joining you all in the room now.
Yeah, I'll
I've got two greater and a regular.
How do I pull up the little thing for the rolls?
Click, click on your token, and then it'll have a thing. Going on.
I have a supreme, a superior, two greaters.
Oh, nice.
I have three more greater, one supreme, one superior.
I got rid of the Supremes and Superiors in the bag, but I think the
like all the little the ones
regulars are accurate, because I took out 4 last time. So we have 9 regular and 11 greater.
Yeah, so if we want to start chucking those.
I'm going to use
30. So let's save the big boys.
Yeah.
As much as we can.
I'm going to use a greater just to...
I'm going to use
11. Yeah, that's fine. I'll be good.
Right now.
I only have one more greater healing potion. I might just save.
We got a bunch in the bag.
Yeah. Okay. Let me just down this one then.
Take 2 from the bag.
I think Malthus overall did a lot more damage than Osei did.
He got his big fuck you ability twice.
Yeah.
Fuck us up.
I am a little sad that they didn't get to steal any of your weapons, though.
If you're using it from the bag, let me know, because I'm editing it right now.
I just used all of my graders that were in my inventory.
I used the one I had in my inventory.
Okay. Cool.
Which I'm down to 1 superior, 1 supreme, and 1 grader.
Then I'm going to take an additional grader.
I'm going to go in the bag, though.
Trey, tell me what you're taking, and I'll edit it.
Okay. I'm going to toss Toros. Toros, I'm going to toss you. It looks like this little like grayish potion. As I'm going to toss you a potion of Hill Giant Strength.
Oh yeah, baby!
I'm going to grab the potion of Frost Giant Strength, and I'm going to grab three of
those. Okay. Put those in your inventory on there.
Okay. Yep. Or I was put the stone giant one.
Yep.
Or hill
stone
giant.
Okay.
Hill giant puts you up to 19.
Yep.
No, hill giant is 21.
21.
Ooh, 21.
Huge.
Frost giant's 23.
Yes,
I believe so.
25.
But it's only last 1d4 round.
Okay. Because
it's the Gick one.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. Frost is 23.
Frost
yes.
is 23.
Okay. I'm that take, exactly puts me at my max. Okay.
I'm going to take a additional regular healing potion. If and you're I'm low like, on regular, if you're low on healing potions, I recommend just taking one or two.
But, yeah. I'm going to give the last two graders two wounds because he's.
I'm going to use three.
Or the last two that I am.
Myself.
So wound heals.
27
plus. 27. Wound is only down 12 hit points now. I'm going to take one more of the normals to give to him. Oh, perfect.
As well. Perfect. I'm only 9 down.
So now, does T want to use any more healing potions? She's looking a little
hurt. Yeah, she's a little hurt, but she's fine.
Okay.
I've sure? only got one potion. Yeah.
We've got five graders and seven regulars. If anyone wants to grab,
I'm going to grab one. You can mark this. I'm going to grab two of the graders. I'm going to take one and I'm going to store the other one in Wound's saddlebag. And then just grab.
I'll take two regulars.
Go ahead and use them or just hold on.
I'm not going to use them. I'm just going to have them on my person.
Okay. I'm going to also toss. Superior healing potion.
Damn, okay.
As the Malthusian and your switchy.
Let's take the Gick ones just as pop people back up as well. Get those out of there. So the two regulars do 1d4 plus 2.
Yeah. How many of those?
We have two.
I might also grab one of the greater healing, that last one, because you guys took two. One took two, and
there's
the
three left.
Two.
There are three left.
Okay. I'll still just take one.
Okay.
Okay. In that case, Essa, do you want to take one?
And did you guys ever think that you would actually be burning through all of these healing potions?
No.
Yes. No. Yes. We don't have a primary healer. There, at some point, we were going to do this.
Yeah. I'll take a what potion again, Rami?
A Gick regular greater. Healing.
Yeah.
Oh, a greater. Yeah. Do you want to take the graders?
I'll take a grader to just restock myself back to two.
All right, we've got one and five regular healing potions.
I'll take two of the regular.
Okay.
So many potion rolls.
Two of the regular, and I'm gonna take one of the Gick ones.
Okay. So Taurus, you got the hill giant.
Yep.
I'm also going to just toss the. Little giant one to. Never mind. Save that.
The
I was thinking about if they get like grappled, it's not a bad idea just to chug one and try and burst.
That'd be hilarious.
But there are worse ways.
There are.
What if she gets counterspelled?
Oh my god.
Good waste of a counterspell.
Listen, give her the potion so that when she runs out of spell slots, she can just start decking people.
You have no idea how much Alice wants to do that.
She may be out of spell slots, but she's not out of options.
No, she is. She very much is.
That was raw, bro. That was raw as fuck, dude.
That was raw.
Cool. Before we do anything else, I need to go to the bathroom really quick. So while we're finishing healing up, we want to take a quick bathroom break.
Yeah,
oh, boss, we're in the middle of a dungeon.
Listen, okay, when nature calls.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'll pause the recording.
Oh, Claudius comes in as overall.
Okay. Really so we're back now. Okay, so you all have divvied up your potions. You've done your healing. You guys want to go through that door?
I imagine we put all of the healing potions in a keg. And it just draws out.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Alright. So, you open the door.
With the key.
With the key. And you all see it leads into another octagonal teleportation room, this time with a purple teleportation circle in it.
Let's see where it goes. And we hop in.
Yeah.
Hop in, I believe.
Oh, yeah.
Here all right. Go. Just going to put you all together again.
Trying to scoop myself. There we go.
All right. You find yourselves in another teleportation room with a door.
Open the door.
Yeah.
Opening the door, you see that this room has another kind of like altar in the center of it with another, this time, a golden key in the center, on a dais.
Are there more of the scribbles like there were in previous rooms?
You do see on the dais itself, you see that there's an inscription. I am writing it out in Discord.
Gotcha.
The inscription reads, "Rejoice, children of Claudius. Nemain's glorious favor shall bless the blood of her right hand."
Oberon sees this and just gives a sigh.
And you also see that standing next to the dais is a sort of like a bowl-shaped thing on a pedestal.
Mm-hmm. And Oberon doesn't even, like, turn to look at Edgar to even inquire about this. He just instantly starts marching up to the dais.
Mm-hmm.
And he's just gonna go, and he takes one of, like, his hand axes, and I think he knows where this is going, and just slashes the palm of his hand and holds it over the bowl.
Yeah, you hold it over the bowl. As your blood drips down into the bowl, you see the words on the dais brighten, like light up with a magical light, as your blood that has pooled at the bottom of this bowl suddenly just disappears. And you hear that shatter noise that you recognize from the other times that the cages around the keys have been destroyed.
Gonna lie, it would have been sick if it didn't work because Oberon was disabled.
That would have been great.
And force Edgar to do it, that would have been funny as shit.
That would have been cool. In Edgar's current state, that would have been.
I'm not
bad.
Yeah, and Oberon, like almost with disgust, just grabs the golden key.
Yeah. All right. You now have collected the golden key.
And goes to the door, opens it with the key.
Yep. You open that door, and what you see is another teleportation room, this time with a green teleportation circle.
And we go through it.
Yep. You go through that room, and you find yourselves at the green teleporter that was beyond the room that Osei was in.
And I think we just head back to the main room, because yeah. I think we've got all the keys.
Yep.
Nice.
So yeah, you all make your way back. By the way, like, at this point, you guys have teleported, like, so much that you've definitely
Oberon has severe heartburn.
You all have heartburn, you've got nausea, some vertigo, like, it's been a lot of teleportation.
Oh my god, yeah. Not vertigo. Oh, That's
getting
so
spins.
Bad.
Mm-hmm. As you all return to the antechamber, you see that large imposing door with the seven slots on it. Is also the slots are glowing very intensely.
Let's just think we've got insert these.
Yeah.
And Oberon's going to start just putting them in.
Yeah. As you put each key into each slot, corresponding color, they brighten to the point where, like, the entire room is just like a blaze of rainbow light. Well, not necessarily rainbow, but a blaze of all this light shining through. And as you slot the golden key into the center, you hear this very loud chunk, like stone lock undoing itself, and the door slowly grinds open, leading to another teleportation room, this one with a gold teleportation circle.
I think that we're getting close to the end. If anybody has anything that they'd like to do before we go through, I'd recommend doing it now. As Oberon, upon saying that, is going to dig his heels into the stone and activate his Wayfarer boots, giving him expeditious retreat for the next 10 minutes.
Okay.
Which
Edgar's going to stab himself and activate his primal avatar.
Okay. Let's do a roll for primal avatar. Now, here's the thing. I'm going to say we could do the roll. We definitely could do the roll. But I would also like to ask Edgar, in this moment, does he feel more connected to his Sylvan ancestry or to his Asori ancestry?
His OGs.
Edgar is disgusted because he did the damage in the Asori form.
Okay.
He does not want to think about that side right now.
Gotcha. In that case, we're going to roll as normal because the roll is weighted towards the Sylvan form.
There we go.
And that is where you take.
What normally has like a still, like there's the undertones of malice, but like in a very fey vibe of like it's trickery, it's still whimsy. The whimsy is gone. It is just what were beautiful butterfly wings are just kind of curtained behind him as like a blood ape that drags across the ground, as it's just nothing is flowing in this version of Sylvan Edgar.
Any other preparations anyone wants to make before going through the teleportation?
I will be right back. I have to go do something real quick. Shouldn't be longer than like a minute or two, but I am going to activate Giants.
Okay. My Reaper's form.
Okay.
We'll suit up, and Tauros will fiendish form.
I think when Essa is turning, you can see that there's a lot more strain he has to put into the form to even just kind of call it out.
Mm-hmm.
Like his body normally trembles, almost kind of like just kind of trembling when he transforms normally. It's full on shaking as he calls out the form, and like it grows very slowly over him, almost like an infection kind of starting from his throat, and then that kind of greenish smoke kind of descending on his form before he fully turns.
Okay.
He is visibly uncomfortable.
Alright.
The moment we're entering, right before stuff, I'm going to bless the front line. So me, Tauros, Oberon.
Okay. So T, do you want to transform into your hag form before going through the teleportation?
I kind of want to wait until we're actually in combat, because I'm worried that like there's going to be shit talking that eats up my time and my form.
If you look at Edgar, and I think I could speak for Oberon on this, I don't think there is going to be our dad is in trouble.
Fair. I'm going to hold off because I'm always stingy with my form.
Mm-hmm. And, so, Tauros, you said you are changing?
Yeah, the wings come out.
Yeah. I went ahead and changed your token for you.
Shank you.
Oh, goodness.
I don't want to change it yet, but
Alice, oh,
someone's vibrator.
Missed a call from my mom.
Mm-hmm.
She's going to be mad.
I'm going to mute myself.
I heard you, Zach.
All right. What did Zach say?
Don't worry about it. It was disgusting.
Zach.
Yes. No, the time has passed.
All right, I'm just gonna pause the recording while we wait for everyone to get back. Okay, so you all have major preparations. We've got Giant Smite and Lightning Crown, Sylvan Form and Bless on Tauros, Edgar and Oberon. Tauros is in his fiendish form. Essa is in his Reaper's form. And T is holding off until we actually see what we're facing. Okay. So, you all move forward to the Golden Teleportation Circle. And as you teleport in, you find yourselves in another octagonal room in a hall that leads into a hallway that leads into another much larger octagonal room. As you all approach, you will see there is several pylons that seem to be forged out of crystal. You can go ahead and move yourselves into the room. I'll just go ahead.
Okay.
Because there won't be any immediate reactions to you all just walking in. Just arrange yourselves. I'll say you don't arrange yourselves further along than behind this yeah. line.
Perfect.
Gotcha.
Cool. That's where it was.
Here, Jack, you can drop the line.
Okay.
I got you. Oh, there.
And then we will move Woon up here. Okay. So, what you see as you walk into this room, you see a large octagonal room. Towards the back of the room, you see a several crystal pylons coursing with magical energy. Standing at one of the pylons, you see an elven woman sort of like working on things, and you see this massive humanoid figure with six arms clad in armor, each arm gripping a different weapon. And then in the very center of the pylons, you see a large dome within which you see two slabs. Upon those slabs, you see the resting figures of both Regulus Claudius and Regulus Claudius the 30th. Upon entrance, looking down, you'll see the elven woman steps out from behind the pylon, and she has this sort of like raised look on her face. And she says, "I'm very sorry, but Grandfather Claudius isn't seeing anyone right now. He's in the middle of something very important. Me and my lovely wife will be happy to attend to you." As she gestures to the demon, the six-armed demon, who just kind of like cracks her neck and says, "Right. Guess where it's time to start."
Not even paying attention to them, but for like a second, like half a second, like acknowledges them as threats, but his eyes just lock at the center where his father and grandfather are. And just is going to shout out, knowing that both, but at least his grandfather, can hear him. "This is where it ends. One way or another."
Edgar rushes.
Yeah, and we'll see what happens on the next episode. Sage.
Let's fucking go!